My name is Bethany Ann Ludwig, and I am a graduate student at the University of Toronto here. I am part of the Dunlap Institute, and I study massive stars and how they interact with each other, the effects of their evolution, and how someday they might become gravitational wave sources. I am also pansexual. I use she, they pronouns. And I was born and raised in Southern California, very close to where Dr. Sally Ride was also born and raised. And I also did my undergraduate degree at the University of California in San Diego, where she was a professor after being an astronaut, the first American woman to be an astronaut. And I guess you could say that her being a formative figure in my path to becoming an astrophysicist is like a little bit of an understatement. So it's 1977. Dr. Sally Ride is doing her PhD like I'm doing now. She's studying about how X-rays interact with the cosmic stuff between stars. During her studies, she came across this completely unprecedented ad in the Stanford newspaper. And what was so special about it was the first time that NASA was reaching out and asking specifically like women and minorities to consider applying to be astronauts for their program. So Dr. Ride sees this and she's like, wow, that could be really cool, right? And she decides to apply. And so Dr. Ride applies to become a mission specialist astronaut, and she becomes one of five women out of 8,000 candidates to be accepted to the program. So as Dr. Sally Ride is being hired and trained by NASA, engineers here at the University of Toronto were working on this series of robotic arms that were going to be attached to a space shuttle so that they could capture and maneuver payloads. And this was referred to as the Canada arm. Dr. Ride made many trips to Toronto to help develop and learn how to use this like extremely tricky piece of equipment. Since she became an expert on the Canada arm, NASA chose her in 1983 to go on one of the first shuttle missions, and that immortalized her as the first American woman in space. Being the first American woman in space was an especially heavy burden. Many people didn't think that a woman's place was in space. And people who did saw her as this feminist icon that was gonna be the future for women everywhere. So like no pressure, right? America was barely ready for a woman in space, much less a queer woman in space. If having a woman in space was one step forward for womankind, then being queer could have at the time been a step backward. So Dr. Ride was exceptionally private and guarded about her personal life, even with people who were close to her. That was the price she paid for being the first American woman in space. She was not able to be herself publicly. She was not able to love who she wanted to love. And she did have deep and meaningful relationships with other women. Her official public coming out was actually in the last line of her obituary, which came as a surprise to even people who knew her pretty well. It said that she was survived by her same-sex partner of 27 years, Dr. Tam O'Shaughnessy. Learning this, I felt deeply moved because this person who was brave enough to sit on top of what is essentially a bomb and be one of the first pioneering people to be launched into space would also at the same time be so afraid of an intolerant society that they would not love who they wanted to love in public. Despite being known primarily as an astronaut, Dr. Sally Ride was actually only at NASA for about 9 years. Her career, both before and after that, was focused on doing research in astrophysics. So after NASA, she got a professorship doing astrophysics at the University of California in San Diego. She and her partner founded a nonprofit in 2001 called Sally Ride Science, and its agenda was to get children interested in STEM and science. One of the programs they ran through the nonprofit was called MoonCam, which stood for Moon Knowledge Acquired by Middle School Students. This program used a camera on the Grail spacecraft that students could use. They could do a proposal and find places on the lunar surface to image. And this had a very big lasting impact on the students who did it, because regardless of gender, they were able to see for the first time that they themselves were capable of doing advanced science. Dr. Ride also wrote a children's book about her experience with space travel. It was her belief that the biggest impact she could have on the world would be to increase scientific literacy, especially including both women and other minorities. To this day, Dr. Sally Ride continues to be a stellar source of inspiration for the scientific community and the world at large, both for women and the queer community also. Happy Pride!